New information tonight about the bicyclist who was killed after colliding with a train in downtown Carlsbad last night. Good evening. I'm Steve Atkinson.
And I'm Lindsay Pena in for Kimberly Hunt. Tonight, we're learning more about the man who died. 10 News reporter Matt Boone is live where it happened. And Matt, this crossing has been the site of tragedy before.
Lindsay, Steve, it is a busy pedestrian and vehicle area out here. Lots of bars and restaurants in the area. And now there are bells and these arms that come down warning people of approaching trains, but it's still very easy to get close to the tracks.
The coroner has identified the man as 37-year-old Jason Holzinger. Investigators say he was riding his bicycle on the sidewalk when he came to the intersection where the train tracks cross Grand Avenue in downtown Carlsbad. According to the coroner's report, despite the crossing arm being fully lowered, he rode around it, colliding with the side of the train. The medical examiner ruled it an accident. The safety of this rail crossing, however, has been called into question in the past. In 2017, the family of Patrick Tarrin filed a lawsuit against the BNSF Railway and the city of Carlsbad, which they argued had negligently, carelessly, and wrongfully failed to properly warn persons crossing the railroad tracks. Tarrin was killed in 2014 after a night of bar hopping with his sister and friends. He had crossed under the bar before it had come all the way down, while the rest of the group waited behind. Despite standing several feet off the tracks, he was struck and killed. The family's lawyer pointed out the crossing arms only come down on the side with oncoming traffic, and that there's no paint or markings on the other side that would show a pedestrian where to stand that is a safe distance away.
Now, the city and Sandag have been looking at ways to make this area of tracks safer. Right now, the option that they're considering is digging a trench through this part of the city. However, that plan would cost well over $300 million to construct. Reporting live tonight in Carlsbad, Matt Boone, 10 News.
Thank you, Matt. And this tragedy happened just 2 days after Operation Clear Track, meant to raise awareness about railroad safety. It was hosted by Carlsbad Police, Amtrak Police, and Operation Lifesaver. Operation Clear Track is the largest rail safety law enforcement initiative in the U.S. It coincides with Rail Safety Week, which runs from September 22nd through the 28th.